I got a call from a lady who said her husband had passed away a few years back and she was ready to sell his car collection. She wasn't going to separate it out. I had to buy everything. So that's what I did. The only thing I really wanted was this cabriolet ride here. So I brought it back to the shop, turned it over to Aaron and the guys, and I said, here's what I want. Late 50s, early 60s hot rod, the way it would have been, the way they would have built it then. You got a budget of about $7,500. Make it happen.
With my budget in mind, I picked a route that we could get the best look and the best bang for our buck. And that meant the wheels and tires had to go. So we ditched the 15s. Although they were cool, they weren't going to work for me. My first call was to Coker Classics. They knew exactly what we needed, and they got them in the mail so we could get them quick. I've actually put a radial tire on that looks like a bias ply. We get the looks we want, we get the drivability, braking, and turning ability out of a radial.
When we first got the car, the dash was still painted red and the tires were painted red, and they were two different colors of red. We took out the dash, painted it to match the wheels, and then we had KC shine up the original vinyl interior with a toothbrush and a bucket. Now they all match. It looks good, sits right, all the way.
I didn't figure that we needed to do too much to the interior, but there wasn't any carpet. Well, not at first, until we started hunting around. It seems that they already had the carpet made, but it wasn't in the car for some reason. So a bonus for us. We got interior, well, we're practically free. So when it comes to motivating the car, well, it already had a pretty good start. It just looked bad. Rather than try and mess with it in the car, we went ahead and yanked the entire driveline, the motor and the transmission out of it. We put high compression Navarro heads on it. We put a real 2.2 intake on it with two Strombergs. We put an alternator on it that looked like a generator, so we got the reliability of modern electronics with the looks of old generator.
Looks good, sits right. The 32 lights were what it was missing the most. Those little bitty headlights just killed the car all the way.
So we put a chrome drop headlight bar on it and two 32 commercial headlights. And you might wonder what 32 commercial headlights are, and they're simply the headlights that came off of a commercial vehicle, a truck, a 1932 truck. They're larger and have a different lens.
Bam! 1932 Cabriolet. Doesn't get any better than this. Doesn't get any cooler than this. And you know what? We did it on time and on budget. Now it's time to sell it.